What do roller coaster loops and the moon's orbit have in common? Well, both of them involve an important force called centripetal force, or the center-seeking force. It's what makes an object in a curved path keep turning. Here's an example. Here I have a bucket filled with water. If I swing this bucket fast enough, the water should stay inside the bucket. Let's test it out. See? But why does the water stay in the bucket?
The water and bucket are both falling in a circular path. The bucket continues to catch the water, as long as your circular motion is fast enough to keep the water from falling out due to gravity. The weight of the water and the push of gravity are acting on the accelerating bucket. When we have an acceleration, we have a net force. When an object is moving in a circular path, the net force is centripetal force, which pulls and directs the object towards the center. The object naturally wants to travel in a straight line, but this force keeps it from doing so. There is said to be another force pushing the bucket outwards, called the centrifugal or center-fleeing force. However, this is not a real force. Forces should exist from any point of view, but this one only exists from the bucket's perspective as it rotates. Centrifugal force is the equal and opposite reaction to centripetal force, and is actually the effect of inertia, or the tendency of an object to resist a change in its state of rest or motion.
Let's think about a yo-yo being swung around. The centripetal force here is the tension on the string. The centripetal force plus velocity keep the yo-yo swinging. Since it has a tangential velocity, something fascinating is that if the object is released from its path, it will fly off in a straight line tangent. Let's test it out.
You can see here that after I release the ball from its circular path, it goes off in a straight line. This is because the object has inertia and wants to continue what it has been doing, hence Newton's first law. We can calculate the centripetal force with the equation force equals mass times velocity squared over radius. Let's say we have a ball traveling in a circle. The ball, which is the mass, wants to travel in a straight line, but the centripetal force moves it in a circular path instead. Since we have a mass traveling at a certain speed in a circle, it takes a certain amount of force. Say the ball weighs 0.05 kilograms and is going at a speed of 4 meters per second in a circle with a radius of 2 meters. Solving it, we get a centripetal force of 0.4 newtons. You can also see that it would take more force to make the ball spin faster or in a tighter circle due to the object's inertia.
So why is centripetal force important? It can help in designing roads,
creating artificial gravity
for spacecraft, and designing amusement rides. Overall, understanding centripetal force is important in many aspects of our daily lives.
Thanks for watching, and may the centripetal force be with you.